Good morning, I'm Jay Struberg, and this is your Early Rush. This morning, people in Florida are preparing for a major hurricane to hit the state's Gulf Coast. Right now, Tropical Storm Idalia is swirling in the Gulf of Mexico. It's expected to strengthen into hurricane status before making landfall in Florida. Governor Ron DeSantis has declared a state of emergency for 33 counties. Experts warning the storm could bring a storm surge of up to 11 feet. Many areas could see powerful winds, heavy rain, and flooding. Our Lydia Vasquez in Tampa has a look at how residents are preparing.
Every time there's a storm, I usually get sandbags, and it's a good way to protect water from coming into my garage.
10 sandbags later, Emily Rogers says she's not taking any chances.
It's also good to, because we live close to Hillsborough River, to be safe and protected just in case the water rises higher than you think it's going to rise.
Rogers isn't alone. People stuff their trunks with sandbags as dozens of locations open up to the public ahead of Idalia.
You know, we're college students, so we're just trying to like prepare as best as we can. And we're trying to make sure nothing happens to our apartments.
Officials recommend anyone whose home is at risk for flooding consider picking up sandbags. They also suggest checking your yards for things like debris, which can clog up storm drains and make flooding worse. Sunday, Governor Ron DeSantis held a press conference encouraging everyone to closely monitor this storm after issuing a state of emergency for about half of Florida.
Anybody on this Gulf Coast, certainly from Tampa all the way up to places like Bay County, you should absolutely be very vigilant right now. You should be following the track of the storm, and you should just be making your preparations. Listen to the folks who are the emergency management and the local officials. They are going to be the ones that are going to be issuing guidance on evacuating if there's any road closure.
Meanwhile, officials are encouraging everyone to make a plan.
Things that you should consider. How will we receive our communications and warnings? What is our plan for shelter? What is our evacuation route? What is our internal family communication plan if we should get separated?
It's a good time to make sure you have a basic supply kit, which includes water, 1 gallon a day per person for at least 3 days, battery-powered radios, a flashlight, and a first aid kit.
It's better to be prepared versus not prepared and have regrets.
I'm Lydia Vasquez for Scripps News.